Hey everybody, John Nelson with Haas Automation here to wrap up our series on M-Code Timesavers about how formatting some M-Codes can save you significant cycle time. Let's briefly review the M-Codes I'm referring to, and there'll be links to each of the videos in the description below. First was M1, optional stop. This code by itself doesn't slow program execution, but it does affect the look-ahead function, so the control will not pre-position the tool carousel on machines with side-mount tool changers. Pre-call the next tool with a T code, delete the M1 entirely, or move the M1 after the next tool change to speed up all tool changes by pre-positioning the carousel to the next tool. Also, at the end of your programs, command a tool change to put the first tool in the spindle, or at least pre-position the carousel to the first tool. This will save a few seconds at the start of your programs. It's worth noting here that machines with carousel-style tool changers, where the tool changer is inside the enclosure, will not benefit from this change because the tool changer cannot pre-position for the next tool. Then, there was M5 and M6. M5 is the spindle stop command, but you should not use this code before tool changes because it causes the control to wait for the spindle to decelerate before continuing program execution. Remove the M5 and the codes to move to tool change position. Allow the M6 tool change command to perform both functions simultaneously. This can save a couple of seconds on every tool change, especially if the spindle is running at high RPM. The next video was about M88 and M73 codes, which are through spindle coolant on and through tool air blast on. Don't start the spindle before using these codes. If you do, you'll just have to wait for the spindle to stop and then start again, which can cost a second or two each time you run that tool. By the way, this also applies to tapping cycles. There's no need to turn the spindle on with an M code before a tapping can cycle because the G code for that cycle will start the spindle in the correct direction. And finally, we talked about M10 through M13. For rotary axis brakes on machines with two rotary axes. Cut brake delays in half, basically from 6 to 3 seconds, every time you position both rotary axes by eliminating the unnecessary M codes and positioning both axes in the same line of code. So let's review the time savings in my short little three-tool program that just faces the top of stock, cuts a profile around the outside, and drills two holes. The original cycle time was 56 seconds. When I deleted two M1 codes at the end of each tool path, it reduced the cycle time by 4 seconds. Next, I deleted the M5 spindle stop command and the G53Z0 command to send the machine to tool change position, and instead let the M6 tool change command process those functions simultaneously. I also added a tool change at the end of the program to put the first tool in the spindle so it doesn't wait for the side mount carousel rotation at the beginning of the program. These changes saved me another 3 seconds. My final change in this program was to start the spindle on the drilling operation after the M88 through spindle coolant on command. This saved me another 2 seconds because that tool runs at high RPM. Altogether, my cycle time went from 56 seconds to 47 seconds. Now, it's not fair to give a percentage of cycle time reduction because most of these savings come from tool changes. But I can say that on machines with side mount tool changers, you can save between 2 and 4 seconds on every tool change if you follow my instructions about ditching the M1s and M5s. You'll save another second or two depending on RPM if you start the spindle after M88 or M73. If you're running a program that has 10 tools and two of those tools use through spindle coolant, this recipe could reduce your cycle time by 30 seconds. What's your lot size? 100 parts? Save yourself 50 minutes on the whole job. Is your lot size 1,000 parts? I just saved you 8 hours and 20 minutes. You're welcome. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.